So,
of course I was gonna have him killed until I had, what is your name again? He says, turning to the Toydarian.
Dunga.
Yeah, Dunga. Do it for me.
Oh yeah, I totally killed him. He's dead, for sure. Honey, don't check.
Yeah.
I'll cry.
Oh, I'll check, all right.
I'm real sad, don't check.
No. I don't need a check. Because, of course, you know, it's the reason I'm here in person to take care of this this bastard who showed up, tried to hone in on my territory. Standard hut funeral procedure, have his best friend take this gun. Uh-huh. So hand it to Dunga, Durga, Dumba.
Dumbo. The name's Dunga.
Dumbo.
Okay.
Take this gun and go.
You're my boss.
Go and desecrate the corpse of your best friend by shooting him in the head right now.
Right.
Oh, wait a minute. Not just yet. Hello. Well, I haven't been introduced to the two of you. Little beautiful arm candy. Waltzes into a room and I don't have her on.
That's the nicest thing anyone's said to me all day.
Who do you think I'm talking to? He already comes with the chain and everything. Somebody put a collar on his neck.
What?
Oh.
One of your own collars.
I did not expect to like this much.
Yeah, get over here, he says, tying the collar that's around your neck and dragging over. Perfect. Hey, come on. He says, all right, a little beautiful arm candy.
I just want to try something. Oh, yes, that works. Anyway, okay. Continue.
You can do that. I like that, too.
Oh, don't press the blue one, too. Anyway.
So, Gringa, the hut, has a pole in on a chain.
We'll get you into, like, a bikini or something later.
Oh, I want to see that.
It's going to be good.
With my eyes, though.
get that Ewok off, huh? Hurry up, Dumbo, go shoot your friend in the face.
Aye, aye, here I go.
Okay, wait. I get on Yerp, and Yerp stands over Gringo's body. And they go, now you, not best friend, me.
Uh-oh, giant rancor in way. Guess I can't do it.
Guess we gotta kill them all, huh?
No.
Who are you? Who are you? Who are you?
That's
what I thought.
Okay.
Who is she?
She's catering. Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's right. I'm here. I brought sandwiches.
Oh, good. Okay. Well, go ahead and.
Did you need something to eat?
Yeah, go ahead.
I might have some poison in my bag to put in one of these sandwiches real quick.
Well, don't do that.
Why'd you say it out loud?
I didn't say it for you.
Weird.
Not to you. I'm just
poison.
Saying, no,
I love
no, no.
Poison. Some of my favorite foods are poison. I'm a hot. It takes now, go ahead and pass out some of those catering trays. You got all the catering taken care of, right, Dumbo?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I did that.
Okay.
Oh.
There's some silver, like, chafing dishes and trays over there.
Oh, yeah, here.
I have a
We're
plan.
Gonna kill you in a minute. Go ahead.
Here's what I'm gonna do.
I'm so glad you're all here, by the way, because finally, he's dead. I'm gonna kill the rest of you, and no one's gonna be in the way of Gringa's
gambles. Wait, are you gonna kill me?
No, baby, come here.
And his like giant tongues all flopping around.
All right, good, I was worried there.
Slaps with the tongue so hard, it like stings. Yes,
just press the blue button.
I'm going to use the well-established Rancor's can vomit on command.
Yes.
That's come up several times.
Has come up several times mm-hmm. to get Yerp to throw up on or near Gringo, because I know that in there are some body parts that I can pretend belong to Gringo.
This is a flawless plan.
Vomit
flows over Gringo. So Gringo, this is the point where I should reveal you are still alive.
Yeah. I'm gonna jump out of there as soon as I see that vomit, actually.
Risk reward, high risk, high reward. So I am going to say that your dice that were donated to earlier, I do want them to come into effect right now.
Okay.
High risk, high reward. So just off screen, time to get a little. This must have all been a long, long scheme you had.
The longest con.
I was trying to let them think you were dead still.
Well, Rancor vomit comes flooding into the. Would you jump out? I would let you make a resilience check to try and lay in a coffin filled with vomit.
Okay, I'm terrible at that.
Okay.
Resilience check.
As Kaveri goes out to get the catering.
As though,
she opens up like the silver, just like lifts up the top, guns. filled with guns and weapons and all the catering trays. Underneath, like, there's canapes on top of them, but you pick that up, put it down.
She was prepared for this. Grango was prepared, for this.
Yes, and Grango, yeah.
What am I rolling against?
Rancor vomit. Got to be a little bit acidic, no, so I think it's going to burn.
Though. It's low. They use it as perfume. It's low.
Yeah. The ambergris.
Yeah.
Oh. Thank you, BSB Care. I love it. Okay, so let's just make it two purple. Standard difficulty.
It's only against one green.
You guys have all light side points on the board. Yeah, there's nothing I can do.
I will bounce that
I gotta up.
Do it.
All right, this is one yellow against two purple plus my gambling dice. My chance cubes. That's actually good.
That's so a success because of your chance cubes.
Yes. Like,
what are the
chance cubes?
So having a red and a blue means one success and I take two strain.
Great.
So I have that, plus I get one advantage.
Okay, great. So a success so because
15,
of your chance cubes.
Dom, if you haven't switched me over. Yeah. Yep. Thank you.
And an advantage. So you do manage, if you want to just lay in there. You definitely take strain as the vomit is just seeping into every crack and crevice. And I'm going to give you an extra, just one strain on top of it, because it's a terrible situation to be in.
What if I wanted to...
Yeah, come with me. Come with me, Sergeant Johnst, was it?
And Grenga turns away for a moment and, like, starts making out with them in a horrible way.
So since we didn't discuss this plan of me being like this, is there a point when I know to come back to life? Or am I choosing that opportunity? Mm. Like, is there... Do I have, like... P9L somewhere also stashed ready to come out with a gun.
Mm-mm.
Like, what have I planned?
Yeah, is this, like, I figured it was a make sure Grenga thinks he's dead and mm-hmm. then goes away.
Yeah.
Was your plan?
I think the plan is you went in, win that one game of Sabacc, maybe really hoping that you would win it, and you did win it.
Right.
Grenga cheated anyway, but you were ready for that, so you faked your death, knowing that the hut's going to show up in person to make sure that you're really done. So I think it's a
this
I
is
think
my
it's
chance
to finish him off.
Low security. It's a funeral. Yeah. So this is my.
They're
plan.
Not get the advantage on him and then.
Right. So this could turn to a firefight at one point or another.
I think you're ready for it to
and
turn.
And this
into
is
a
what I wanted it to be.
Yes.
Is I when think... this rancor is about to vomit on me, I want to jump out of the coffin behind it, flip it over, and I have a gun stashed underneath it already.
I love it.
And start shooting it. Grenga.
Okay. I would never have had my rancor puke on you if I had thought that this was the start of a fight.
Right. You didn't know. It's cool.
I saw what was there, and I made a judgment call.
Works for me. So I think we need initiative checks across the board here from everybody.
Which, cool.
Very. Yeah. Catering trays are filled with weapons.
Ooh.
When you, like, lift off the thing.
Awesome.
Yeah. Second... So, everything looks like it's going to go pretty good, so you should probably shout something. So the vomit splashes in on you, or right before you get splashed on?
Right before I get splashed on, so I jump out, flip over the coffin, and pull out...
What? What's like, going on? What is this?
Underneath the coffin is actually like a small turret that I've already got set up.
I should have checked the coffin!
The rumors of my demise have been greatly exaggerated, but not yours!
Greg, how is this possible? Durgo.
The name's Dunga!
Pew pew!
Betrayed by Tordarians, I should have known! Man, everyone gets their guns out.
And I'm going to assume, since this was your plan all along, that the turret he has is hut-piercing bullets, not the bullets that just like bounce off the thick skin, right?
I spent the money.
It's a yes, I'll say that. It's a deadly weapon stashed right into the thing itself.
Because huts are hard.
However, unfortunately at this moment, BSB Care says, Europe needs to go bloodthirsty and a bit crazy. They're not talking their way out of this one. No, they are not.
No, we are not.
So
baby Rancor just loses it.
Yeah, when the dead body comes to life right in front of his face.
Yeah.
The Rancor starts running around. So the Rancor probably had time to rest up, so he's at full stats. The Rancor goes berserk and starts charging into the room. James V. 1971 weighs in and gives Europe a triumph since he's activated now.
Yeah.
So he's going to go charging straight ahead. Okay, Kaveri, you've got a whole host of guns and some people who can use them, but you might have to get them around. Anything you really... There's probably stuff, tons of stuff. Bombs, maybe
grenades. Hell yeah.
whatever you need. And then, Sergeant Johnst, you are kept on on your chain by Granga, who is now pretty much distracted.
Okay.
He was just making out with you, though. He probably tore your shirt off.
Get out of this! Oh, look at those scrawny pecs! This is what I like in a man!
Are we good mic-wise? Are we good mic-wise? Okay,
yeah,
great.
We're sounding good.
Hi.
So we better get initiative checks from everybody. This, in this case, is vigilance because you guys are getting a crazy drop on these guys. I'm trying to.
Okay.
Where's my initiative?
Yeah. Are all of them. They're all yours. You can have them all.
Oh, that's pretty crappy.
Do I just get to make it up?
Okay, so Johnst gets gets to go?
Oh. Johnst gets to go, I guess, yeah.
Fantastic. Mm.
What would his cool rating be?
We established he's pretty damn cool before, right? So wasn't he like a yellow and two green?
Yep.
Yeah, I think so.
Two advantage.
I should have brought stats for him.
Whoa!
Okay, so...
cool as shit.
Yeah, so four successes. And
so Johnst gets to go first, and who had next up?
Next is me, then.
Great, and I'll have Yurt go probably right before you.
Okay.
So you, and then followed by this Rancor, which is rampaging out of the way. You've got quick reactions, son.
Okay, so basically,
Granga's totally distracted by everything that's going on. Kill him! Kill him! Kill him! So
Johnst basically uses his super chain skills to like get a hold of the chain, and then
what? This has never happened before to anybody.
Yeah, and then just run around, like, and just. Go ahead and choke that and start choking that sucker. Because I mean, like.
That's what I would do.
Yeah. It's like, sorry, chains are kind of my thing. Pretty good with them.
What? Oh my god, this has never happened to anybody ever!
Okay, so his big tongue starts flopping out. It's going to take a little effort to start choking him to death. Six armed hooligans burst into the room of the makeshift funeral. With all their blaster rifles out and immediately start opening fire. They're like unseemly swords. We've got an Aqualish with the butt face. We've got a lizard-like Trandoshan in there. Probably a couple of each. Mm-hmm. Pew, pew, pew. Some Weequays just opening fire. All wearing their like stylish leather jackets.
Nice.
I'm gonna get some weapons to these guys as quick as I can.
Okay, he's got a weapon.
Yeah, in fact, I'm on a turret.
He's a turret, basically.
Yeah.
So like the coffin transforms into a turret?
Yeah, just flip it up and then falls to the side.
But it has like the coffin paneling on it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Fancy.
Works for me. So we'll say that does a bunch of damage. We'll give it, we'll say it does like 10 damage.
Okay.
As a base.
And pierces hut armor only?
Pierce's hot armor only. Let's just call it the 10 damage. That's pretty good damage. That'll get okay. Through hot hide. Okay. And you don't have a weapon though, Root, right?
No.
You are at the foot of the coffin turret?
I'm on Yurp right now.
Oh, you're on Yurp, and Yurp is going wild while you're on it.
Yurp's gonna be going crazy, so I figure I'm just gonna be Bucket Bronco trying to hang on for a while.
While Yurp goes nuts. So you come in with the guns and,
yeah.
And hell has broken loose.
Oh my goodness. So I gotta grab what I got in front of me. I got some freaking grenades and stuff too, right?
Yep.
All right, so I'm gonna get one of those grenades out, and then throw it at at least two of those guys together.
Okay.
Yeah.
Lizardy
dudes.
Yeah. Okay, and you are next, right? Did we establish that? Who was? I'm sorry. It was Talene.
Because him, then me, then Kavari.
Okay, great. So you start choking him out. Let's get a athletics check for you.
Okay, so this would be to basically...
Oh, and you don't have any stats for your guy. Great. Let's give you stats.
Yeah, okay.
I think this is probably
Gippy
a good
stats
one.
Seem wrong for him. All right, so this would be brawn.
Yeah, I would do a brawn-based attack, so it would just be three green and... He's definitely trained in it, so let's replace...
One green with...
Let's replace that.
There's melee, too, so...
Oh, melee. Perfect. We'll use melee. So it'll be two green and two yellow and a green.
Yeah, got it. What's the difficulty, buddy?
To choke out a hut?
Yeah. Is that, like, their weakness, or is that, like, something that requires a level of skill?
Well, I mean,
It might be turned on for the first bit of it, so you probably gotta go harder.
Right.
Yeah, it's gonna take some sustained pressure, I think.
Okay.
So let's say it's just three purple.
Okay.
And I'll give you a boost because obviously the universe tends towards this kind of thing happening to us.
Because we're actually citing something that actually happened in a Star Wars movie for a
record. We've been doing this entire session.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All canon.
Okay, so
all
that
the time.
That is a failure.
Bad. That's real bad.
It's a real bad failure. I would like to spend my triumph though.
That's why I always wear this leather choker nowadays.
Yeah.
Hey, re-roll it.
Oh, what?
I need this guy dead.
Okay. You could also drop a triumph.
I'm going to also drop a triumph and a re-roll.
Okay.
Nice.
So, this is a triumph. Whatever it is, and if it's a double triumph, then
the so better. Much the better.
Yes.
Great. So that's a success.
It is a success. One success, it looks like, and two. No.
No, it's no threat. I think it cancels everything out. Oh no, one advantage.
Great.
Two and a triumph.
And a triumph.
Right.
Oh, okay. So, yeah. You see that underneath the folds, that Gringa has this like thick leather like. Choking collar on. Good thing I put this on today. and then you got your reroll. So.
Oh, okay.
What and happens? I guess you call it all. It's all you.
Okay. So for my triumph, I go. Yes, this is allowing me to lean back, and then I just get my little like my little rave thing.
Yeah. Oh.
And then like swing back around and wrap that around his neck.
Oh, you should have taken another weapon away.
And then flip. Like, yeah, just gonna pop his head off like a giant, gross Coke can. Is that possible?
On a double triumph, it would have been. On a single triumph, it's just gonna do a bunch of damage because Huts are tough customers.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'll say you can just do a massive lacerating attack against it.
Alrighty.
Damage for your Kusari Gama. It's called, I think, 8, probably with a pierce of 2.
Okay.
Does that sound
fair? That's exactly the same damage as my baby Rancor.
Yeah. Wow. So it's like Rancor level badass.
That's amazing.
Well, it is the most awesome ninja weapon, so it makes sense. It was established. So it was two successes, right?
Yep.
Great. Okay. Gotcha. Yeah. You just start
so basically the triumph is I managed to basically get my weapon for virtually no reason in order to make this attack.
Oh,
okay, is everybody cool with that? All right, cool.
Okay, so you just start sawing through his neck. Yurp, I was going to have go right before you, right?
Yes.
So Yurp goes charging madly into the room, and
Yurp
I think...
Yurp is going to go cray-cray.
Yeah, and since...
So whatever's in Yurp's way gets knocked out of the way.
Okay, so I think there's, like, the guys are standing in front of Grengar, just shooting wild into the room at probably mainly you.
Yeah.
Choo, 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 choo. Laser bolts, and then... Yurp just comes boom, knocks like the two guys in front out of the way, and then
this is what I'm thinking could possibly happen. Yurp sees the tail of Grenga, grabs it, and shakes Grenga like a dog with a toy.
Is what I'm gonna tell you what does happen.
Nope.
I think he smashes headlong right into the Sergeant John's
probably
hut mess and slams into the hut that way. Do you want to tell me how much is that? I think that's basically an attack. He's just wilding out. So why don't you make an attack roll?
Okay.
But I think it's gonna target you and the hut.
Okay,
both
fair enough.
Right. Hooked together.
What is the difficulty?
Because it's kind of a wild, out of control thing.
He's got
just two purple.
I'm gonna use. Can I use my boost on him? My last
absolutely,
boost?
If you want to, yeah. So this Rancor, baby Rancor, so it's only about 6 feet tall.
Mm-hmm.
Still tall enough. Giant slashing claws.
Go! Hey, get off of me!
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Huge
mm-hmm.
success.
Cancels. So that's two success and two advantage. And I'm gonna drop a triumph on that.
You have a triumph
whoa.
Too.
Yeah.
Oh,
Yurp has a triumph. So.
Oh yeah, Yurp does have a triumph.
Right. Yeah.
Oh my god. Okay, so that's the second triumph that this HUD has had. How much damage did we say that just did?
So that's, Yurp does 8 with a pierce of 2, and this is, the critical's at 3, so this is not a critical.
Okay.
So it's 10 with plus 2.
Yeah.
Okay. Jeez, and another crit. Which do you want to spend that triumph? Do you want that to be a critical wound against the hut, or do you want
yes,
it to be
something else?
Yes, it does. Okay, I need to roll twice from with my D100s here. 54 for the first one. 26 for the second one, plus 10, so a 36. So let's say one of his giant bulging eyes, he's like, bruh, bruh. This is inspired by you, Braid. Bah! Oh. Blood vessel bursts in it, and it's just flooded with blood. That's from you choking him out.
Yeah.
And then the Rancor comes crashing onto him, and I think, I like that it goes for the tail. Bites into the tail and just like cuts off the end 2 feet of hot tail.
And then throws the end of the tail against the wall, and it lands on something and breaks
Splat.
It.
Splat. Yeah, it's a framed picture of
Trumpo.
Trump of the Hutt.
Trump of the Hutt.
Yeah. How ironic. You also took 10 damage. You can subtract your soak from that.
Yeah, so I only take 5. So I'm at wound 9.
Okay.
I think sorry about that. Rampaging Yurp. What
still
can you
out of control, though. Yeah. It is your turn.
My turn is just
and then
to
the bad guys go.
To not fall off. So I'm just going to do a. Like a.
Yeah, I would take coordination athletics.
Coordination.
Yeah. Probably coordination, yeah. Just hang on to Bucking Bronco. He's, yeah. 3 purple, hard, difficulty.
You know what? I don't want to die.
Ah, she flipped it.
Flip it.
Do it, do it, do it, do it, do it.
Oh, good. Nice. I definitely don't die.
Yeah.
Yay! Looks like 2 success and 1 advantage.
Yep, 2 success and 1 advantage.
Okay, great. So you hang on high. 2 success, 1 advantage.
Yes.
Advantage, you want to regain a strain? Are you good on that?
Oh man, I can't stand up.
Yeah, I'll regret this strain.
I mic'd myself in wrong. Tied to the chair, so. The gunmen attack. Their blaster bolts are zipping all around the room around you. I'm gonna do an attack on each person here.
Okay.
Sure.
Yeah. Thank you.
3 green, 2 purple.
So we'll start with, probably not on Johnst, because Johnst is tied up with their boss.
Fair enough.
And has a Rancor on him. So over to Kaveri, you take 7 points of damage. No, I'm sorry, it was only 1 success. So let's call that. Sorry.
And what about your disadvantage? Your, that's not the right word.
Threat.
Your threat. Failure.
Sorry.
Sorry, chat.
Threats. Can you even take this chat?
Take what?
David is re-microphoning.
Oh, the terrible danger that we are in this fight?
We are in a lot of danger right now.
It is actually pretty frightening.
Fine.
I mean, like, half of us have technically died already, so it's kind of like...
Yeah.
Sorry about that, everybody.
It's been a real bloody night.
We're at a funeral, so you know.
Yeah.
Someone's gotta die.
Yes. Okay.
Because the person who was dead wasn't really dead.
Gotta no. replace the dead dude.
I have it all figured out, okay?
When sure.
started vomiting on me.
Sorry.
Thank you. Okay, so that was 6 points of damage to you. You can subtract your soak from that as you just caught in the shoulder from a stray blaster bolt. Across the room.
Oh, this is me next?
I guess it's actually probably.
So 3.
Probably.
So here. I'm going to say the guy who was going to shoot at you, there are 2 of them are going to shoot at you.
Yeah, probably.
First shot.
So I'm at 9 for wounds, yeah.
Miss.
Misses Yerp! Because it's scared. It's fear. It's the fear just makes him go.
Yeah. He's shooting at the ceiling here. He's out of his mind. Ooh. That, however, here? Is God. A solid hit. Ooh. So the next one is
a problem.
Yeah.
8 points of damage with an advantage. So the guy does a really cool, like, tucks his gun in and then, like, rolls to cover behind, like,
poor Yerp.
A potted plant in the corner. Yep.
Is that for Yerp or you?
That was for Yerp.
And then a little suppressing fire on you as you're hunkered down. You also have some cover, so I'm going to give him a setback. Oh, yes. Awesome. Another hit. So that is 5, 6, 7, 8. You also take 8 points of damage.
Oof. Woof.
Yeah, but they've got a threat on that. Excuse me.
I'm at 6 done.
Do you want to know, do you want to put Yerp's hit points up there?
No.
Everyone loves Yerp.
Save Yerp. Okay. Hashtag save Yerp.
Hashtag save Yerp.
You're like, organic wing, the non-cybernetic one, gets singed as a blaster bolt, shoots across.
Oh, I just got that fixed, you sons of bitches!
The other guy looks around to try and do a sweet roll behind some other cover, but there's just nothing, because he had 1 threat, so he's just like, nah. Backs up, he'll take a setback on his next shot as they just are continuing to open fire.
Oh!
Groans. Granga, clutching its bleeding throat. One huge blood red eye the size of a cantaloupe.
Kill him! Kill him! Don't let him out of here! This is the end of it!
Zombie Wolf 72 is a follow!
Yeah.
Thank you, Zombie Wolf 72. And thanks Kiganis. For the follow!
Kiganis
gave some money. Kiganis 39.
Kiganis!
Thanks for the money.
It's your turn, Kaveri.
Yeah.
Dunga.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Has his little gun out. Yeah. The gun that Granga gave him to shoot you in the head, and he's like fluttering around wildly, going no.
So probably make take a shot at the goons.
I think he's just trying to avoid gunfire at this point.
Okay. Fair enough.
I still have all these weapons near me, right?
You've got a ton. You've got an
So I can just throw some stuff. So I got another little
if you want a grenade.
Grenade, yeah.
Ranged light against just two purple to just blow some people up.
All right. Ranged light. Do-do-do-do-do-do. I can do it. I believe in myself. All right. Oop.
All right. Oh, thank you, Kiganis. Hell yeah.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Hell yeah, Kiganis.
Against two purple?
Mm-hmm. All right. Kiganis.
All right, so three green, one yellow, two purple.
Nice.
Yes, good.
Huge
okay.
hit.
So that's three success flat.
Yeah, three success.
Grenade into your hand. Real cool sci-fi grenade. Chuck it. Boom!
Yeah!
Two of the dudes over on the corner just blasted to pieces. This time it's not clone fluids, it's real fluids.
Oh!
Yeah!
Yes!
Blood splatters up against like one of the flat screens with Trumpu the Hutt still on loop on it and just like dripping down over his face. Mm-hmm. He doesn't care, he looks better that way.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else you would do on your turn? You also have a move if you want to.
Oh, hell yeah. And I still got some blasters over here too.
No, you do.
Yeah.
I will just say, you also look down and you do see that there's like another like seven grenades right next to you.
Oh.
You really hope that just seems like a volatile place to
be. I might want to move right now.
Just going
to
give you a heads
up. Just because I feel like you're about to try to make that happen on me, GM. Ah, I feel the clear and present danger.
Yep.
All right, so I'm going to run around out from around that. And then who else do we got?
We can imagine. So two other guys who have not been blown up.
And right, there was that one who just tried to roll away and like had no cover. So I'm going to get that guy because he's obviously out in the open still. So I'm going to come and I have a blaster style.
You're closing ground on him?
Yeah. Actually, from that freaking cart of weapons, there's like a big ass blaster that I can just like.
You're like, I'll pick up this big blaster.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wait, no. This one. Yeah. So it's like a master blaster. All right.
This property of P9L, right? On it.
Okay. What was that?
It's his property of P9L.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Memories.
Black, black.
Shouts the guys, you close ground on him, he brings his gun around on you, and then we're over to the man on the turret himself, Granga.
I'm going just for Granga. I see him in my sights, got a gun, sitting there. So I might hit you a little bit, I'm sorry, I don't know who you are, but you might be a slave forever.
No, you do, that's Sergeant Johnst.
I know Sergeant Johnst?
You met.
Yes, in the first adventure in this series, he was there.
Oh, that's right.
And then you're like, thanks, I gotta peace out and check on my casino.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah, you don't care if your lizard dies.
Yeah, probably not.
Why not?
Yeah. Probably not. It's fine. What's this against? I assume it's gunnery? It's a turret, or
do you want to? Ranged heavy, is what I was
ranged
thinking.
Heavy. Okay, cool.
I think gunnery, if your gunnery is better, but I doubt it is.
It's the same.
Okay, that's fine. Neither of those are okay. Just two purple, if you're not trying to avoid shooting him or the rancor that's on him?
Nope. I see blood.
Okay.
It's my only chance to get rid of this.
It's probably going
to
target all three of you guys equally.
That's fine.
Okay. Sorry.
Throw two purple on that.
Okay.
I got to spend one of my dark side points.
Do I still have my.
Blow up
you don't.
Do I still have these? What time was that? Do you remember?
10:30 now. We'll give you the last use of those.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Awesome. I might
Come
make
on,
it
despair.
Good.
Double despair.
And I'm going
to. I just spent one so you can turn one of those purple.
I'll boost mine
red.
Too. Okay. So we'll just leave it.
Love it. I already flipped mine though.
Oh, whoops! Never mind.
Just okay. Kidding. All right. So what are you rolling really quick?
I am rolling one yellow, one red, two green, and one purple, and my chance cubes.
Love it. So you're behind your coffin,
Lots.
The coffin you were buried in, a gun barrel has flipped out of it. Ooh. The wreath snaps up, and there's the amine reticule in there. It's like, do-do-do-do-do-do, and then you squeeze those triggers. What?
Squeeze.
I want my name back!
Oh, okay.
That's pretty good.
Okay,
right?
Okay. Yeah,
so
yeah,
that's
yeah.
It's two success, and I take two strain, plus two advantage.
Let me roll it.
Oh no!
Triumph. Too good.
Triumph.
Damn! No. That's actually success. Better. That's way better.
Reroll it.
Again?
This is my last one, though, so I hope you do not try
triumph. Triumph. Yeah. Triumph.
That would have hit all of them.
Triumph.
I got a bunch of
them. I forgot it would have killed them. Damn!
Still pretty good, yeah.
Yeah, still pretty good.
But it's pretty bad for them. So that chance cubes are blue, which means that's 3 success, 4 success, 5 success, and 1 threat. 5 success, 1 threat.
Ooh.
Damn, that's really good. That doesn't give me much room to screw you over. I think... Can you describe what this gun looks like as it opens fire directly onto... Onto the hut?
Yeah, this is definitely a gun that I've pulled off a spaceship. It's not meant for...
Was this the one that was in your casino?
The Sidewinder?
Fired? Yes, the Sidewinder.
This is probably the Sidewinder that I reformatted into a coffin gun.
I know would approve.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, so you squeeze those buttons. I think we described it looking like a screaming dragon coming out of... And it's like mouth opens for a second and we get a really cool anime style.
Yeah.
Side shot of it.
Yeah. Revenge is mine!
Yeah, so you hit Gringa dead on.
Dead on!
What? Nobody! No! And then Murphy Brown makeup boiling off as the energy beam. Skin blistering.
Yay.
And then, hut like skeleton flashes down the entire length of the body. Ooh, from the inside.
Nice.
Ooh.
And then there's that like shockwave effect. And then just, ooh, blam, blows the flesh off of the hut.
Yes.
And just charred bones hit the ground.
Yes.
Wow.
How much damage do we take?
So that was 10 plus 5. 15 total is what.
Oh, and then he's like, ugh, I'm okay. No, I may have over-described that. Okay. I like it. No, I think that's good. That was 2 crits from each of you guys, plus that. That's fair.
Yes.
The bones of Gringa are just laying there.
Yes.
The whole back half of the funeral parlor is just blackened. Like the burgundy rug that runs across the entire floor just has this like black burned mark just where the beam passed over the top of it. Lights flicker. Sprinklers come on. What happened to the Rancor and to you who are on top of it?
I think sort of
15
John's,
points of damage?
That puts me at negative 1.
It might be more, but this is what you told me what the coffin gun was, but I don't remember. The Sidewinder was crazy when we looked at the stats, so.
Okay.
We'll go with what you gave
me.
So
yeah, the depowered slightly to turn into
right.
a coffin.
Sure. So it's 15 based on what I rolled.
So
right.
you're at negative 1, yes. So. Just a bloody mess laying on the ground. Horribly burned.
Yeah, pretty much. Just like I don't know, like maybe like my arms are not fused to the chain.
Oh God. So it's bad.
And I'm just like,
oh, your collar is now definitely permanently welded on.
Yeah, right.
Oh,
exactly. Like that Coke can and drop dead gorgeous left in the, sorry, anyway. Yeah. Anyone, deep cut. It's cool.
So you're
if he took 15 points of damage.
So that Yerp is now at 2 points of damage.
Yerp survived that?
Yerp survives that.
Nice.
He's a tough SOB.
You
freaking got Rancor.
You got a little lucky.
I knew what I was doing.
2 more points higher. Yeah.
I knew what I was doing.
So Yerp's like hurt pretty bad, but like not dead. So
no.
Maybe like.
Fine.
Yeah.
Big like burn, burns, black marks,
burns.
Electrical burns all over the side.
Yeah.
is going to give Europe some pretty cool scarring.
Europe's into scars.
Yeah. He already has that cream-colored slash.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
My only question is...
Europe definitely lets out like a big yelp, though. And is like running around like a dog.
Yeah,
like... Firecracker tied to his tail.
Right, because he's still like bloodlusting, but he's like seriously wounded. Oh, right.
That puts him off the bloodlust, I think.
Okay, because I don't think he like...
Or does it?
I don't see him like...
No one has a bigger bloodlust
than me. I don't know that he's got
me.
Run around in him left. I think he's probably got like snap at whatever comes nearby in him.
Okay, yeah, so he's running around doing that.
He's like laying on the ground in pain, and anything that comes near him, he'll attack.
But. Dunga flutters down through the droplets.
Well, we did it, man. We did it.
Ah! Pull out a death stick and light it up.
I'm free now. I can go back to my family. You're gonna be a way better casino operator, right?
Yeah. Something like that.
All right. All right.
Hmm. Not a thing to spend, but I'm gonna stay on it. I'm gonna hang on to it for a second.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. Unfortunately, you annihilated Gringo with your multiple triumphs that you guys were hanging.
Thank you, chat.
Yeah. Thank you, chat. Okay, that's fine. Endor's moon awaits.
Yay!
So I think.
What the hell are you guys doing here, anyways?
What are you doing here?
I died.
But I still don't. Why would you come here?
Hello, look, he's dead now.
Yes.
Mission accomplished. I'm rich.
Oh, good.
Oh, this was all for your casino?
Everything's for my casino.
We're still trying to save like, the galaxy here.
Cash me out, then.
Pretty much unconscious, pretty much wiped out.
You just got to get one last line in there
yeah,
before
that's fine.
He
just
fucking kicks the bucket.
Just
at this
groaning.
Point. Was it good for you too? Dead.
And then that's when I guess the other members of the military establishment start like, you hear their heavily, the jackbooted members of the ground forces of the New Alliance come charging in. And you guys suddenly remember that.
For Yoda's.
Technically, well, that's right. Well, you remember technically that he was supposed to be your handler. You may have just shot him dead. A hut is currently in control of the government.
Let's run!
Killed a hut
in a run away! Run away fast!
It was the Ewok!
No, run away!
Okay, your ship is still docked just outside.
Yeah, let's get back to the
run!
Ship.
Run!
Run!
You guys come out, people start shooting at you. I guess I'll spend my triumph just as gunfire just laces out of you guys. I'm going to do a crit on somebody. Just because I can. Thank you. This is Keganis.
Going to jump in the way. They went that way. I don't know.
Is that better? That
no.
You come back to life with my triumph? No, I don't think that is better. Okay, yeah, so one of you guys is going to take a gunshot wound. And it's going to be one of you three.
Okay.
As you go running. One of you four? Is Europe?
Counting Dunga?
Possible.
Oh,
that's right. Europe.
No.
Oh, that's right. Thematically, it would be cool.
Okay.
But also very sad. I'm so sorry.
Oh, it would be very sad. We'll
but he would protect you.
What are you for? So
what if we say if it's actually if it targets her, Yerp jumps in the way. But only if it targets her.
Well, we'll see what happens.
He wouldn't save me.
So you guys are running.
No, he wouldn't.
You hit the docks. Like you manage to avoid gunfire as you get around a corner. And then, boom! There's the hangar bay. There's your ship, which they're like someone's like. Shut it down! Like, they're trying to close down the hangar so you guys can't get out. You just have a straight run. There's nothing in between you and them. Laser fire's getting close. It's singeing your hair. Let's see who gets hit. So I have a D10, so we're going to call you 1 and 2. No, 1, 2, 3. No, I've got 2. 8. So ignore 9 and 10. I'll reroll 9 and 10. You're 1 and 2. You're 3 and 4. Europe is 5 and 6. Gringo, 7 and 8.
Okay.
She can't even look.
Oh, and I guess Dunga is flying around with you, so he'll be 9 and 10.
Okay, fair enough.
3.
Oh! I knew it!
Was that Europe?
Yeah, no.
That's Root.
Root.
Root, you take a crit as you are caught right in, I don't know, back of the mid-spine.
Ugh.
You hit the ground for a second, your knees give out. Little grunt.
Where's it at? Where'd I got it? It's
right there.
The, this?
Yes. Got him rolled up, let's see what it does to you.
Okay, this is my...
How many?
This is plus 20 now?
Oh, yeah. You already have two?
Yeah, okay. I have two critical ones already.
So you can't die.
Not yet. That's not that
14.
Bad.
14. Oh,
so it turns into a 34.
Everything's
three
fine.
Critical
you've
wounds.
Got plus 30 on your next fight, or on your next time you get hit.
So fine.
You've really been down. Accumulating critical wounds this time. So
yeah.
It's searing pain. Ah. You feel the other old wounds really like suddenly lace with a fiery pain.
The first one was a head wound, so.
Yeah. It's like, and your knees hit the ground for a second, and Europe stops and turns back. And it's like,
Ruth, you okay?
And you struggle back to your feet.
We gotta go!
Can I walk?
Yeah, you're fine. Get back on the ship.
All right. Oh, that was real bad, but I can still move just fine.
Yeah,
I think Yurt probably helps you along.
You rolled a 14, so it's not
too okay, bad. So nice. Yeah. Oh, there's a critical wound, but a mild one. I shake it off.
Yeah, I did that really well. It just burns a big bald patch in your back that's going to take a long time.
Oh, another bald patch, like your toe.
Why my beautiful hair?
Yeah, and like your bald toe. little fingerling potato tall toe that you've got. You get back on board the ship, last takeoff, and we get a beautiful screen wipe to Endor, the surface of Endor. And we'll wrap up the session here, guys, as... ship lands, the ramp goes down, and it's home. Immediately all the pain and everything washes away. It's the same sky. You smell the smells.
I made it.
The leaves have that same sound that the leaves make when the wind blows through the trees. There's little birds chirping. Giant redwood trees around you.
I turn around, I shake Grango's hand.
Me?
What's hey, this? You. Goodbye.
What?
I've made it. Heaven.
What does that mean?
I just walk out into the woods like this.
Wait, that's how you get shot.
Ruth, we're going to need you. Help us find.
Who's going to clean the ship?
We need to find Yoda's brother.
The planet looks a little bit different from before, obviously. The events after Return of the Jedi, there was a pretty large-scale battle on this planet.
Oh, they got a Walmart now. That's nice.
It seems like the opposite, actually, as you guys came in.
Kmart?
No, as you guys came in, it looks like massive large-scale restoration. There's big swaths where, like, you know, a Star Destroyer crashed or whatever, and all the trees are just been, like, destroyed. But, like, they've gotten the Star Destroyer out, and, like, there's saplings there now, but it's only been a few years, so it's clearly a planet recovering. You wander off. As you're about to disappear into the shadows, you see the two of them behind you, like, just clueless about what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
What would you do?
It's okay. You can go. You can dissolve now. I've made it to heaven.
Root, you're not...
Thank you, chubby space angel, for guiding me.
You're welcome.
You just barely showed up.
Wait, since you're...
I never quite figured out your part in this whole thing.
Since you're going, maybe you should give me all your money. You're not going to need it. Just say, you're going to be in heaven.
Root. This isn't heaven. We're on a mission. We're looking for Yoda's... brother right
the
now.
The mission was to reach heaven. Here I am.
As you,
I will turn into light now.
Can't wait for that.
As you guys, you're standing there and you're waiting for something. And you guys are just watching this little Ewok, 3 feet chubby, hands extended to the sky, waiting for Yub-Nub to start. Yub-Nub's gonna start.
Yub-Nub, any minute now. Yub-Nub.
And after
I sing the song of heaven. I'm in heaven.
And Europe is looking real confused and looking around, but then starts trying to like help you beatbox.
We made it.
Let me ask you something.
Yeah.
You don't think I'm chubby, do you?
I wasn't gonna say anything, but since I last saw you, you kind of let yourself
yeah,
go.
Okay.
You're
yeah.
in that yeah.
Yeah. I think. Right. Mm.
A single cold drop of water falls right in the middle of your head. Root is just standing there, and you're, when your eyes open up, just like from one of the treetops way up above you, you see like one of the Ewok settlements in the trees, right? A little treetop village up there. With this, what if you landed near your original home, or did you guys just sit down wherever?
I don't know.
You were probably. They would have been looking to you.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's just wherever?
Mm-hmm. Wherever.
33 is wherever, right? Okay.
I went under 50.
Okay, great. So
over 50, it would have been home.
Home. Okay, that's good. It's an abandoned Ewok village, though. And in fact, unlike the Ewok villages we saw in Return of the Jedi, there's like rings of wooden spikes sticking out of like the trunks that of the trees it's set up on, and like palisades of like, what do you call that? Like stockades, sharp wooden spiked walls and everything like that. It clearly looked like it had been set up for war, and it's empty.
Root, we have to go. I can't build a casino here.
Yeah, it's a federally protected lands.
There's a lot of laws. I don't want to get into it, but no one's here. I think a bird spit on you.
There's like,
I don't, this doesn't make
weird what sounds.
Did you know who lived here?
No, this should be turning into light.
Snap.
A twig snaps somewhere behind you guys.
What's that?
Oh, no.
More weird sounds around you coming out of the darkness. And then roaring out of the trees, tearing into like a really sweet circle. The sickest, most tricked out speeder bikes you've ever seen. Like, they've got, like, sick flames painted on them.
Oh, shit.
And riding on their backs.
Oh, fuck.
Rad Troopers.
Rad Troopers is fucking rad! So fucking rad!
For a moment, you see they're not speeder bikes after all. They look a lot like speeder bikes, except they have these big black rubber wheels that actually touch the ground.
Oh.
Yeah.
They're ATVing?
ATVs.
No, they're riding actual motorcycles.
Oh, through the
trees.
Okay.
What's cooler than riding hover bikes through trees? Actual motorcycles. And like they do like a sweet like wicked half gainer off the back of a thing and like land and form this tight circle around you guys. There's like six or seven of them. Again, like stormtroopers, except instead of the regular black eyeglasses, they've got wicked 80s aviator shades.
Ooh.
Mm. Fucking rad.
Guns out. No. No.
You are kidding me.
All right, it is. Let them go, you will.
Oh, okay. I thought it was, what's his guts, come back. Who? You sounded a little like Christoph Waltz for a second there.
My Christoph Waltz is much better. My Christoph Waltz is when I sound like this.
You sound like Doctor Strange.
Yeah.
I use... Yes.
Harvested and slaughtered.
Yes. No, this is a very cool, very chill voice. Make way. Make way, you will. I wish to see them, do I? Says this diminutive figure who suddenly comes stepping through. You've served me well, my retrained rad troopers. You've learned well from me. Now I'll turn. Oh, yes. Allow me to introduce myself, says Yoda. Is it Yoda? Same height, looks exactly the same except for the backwards baseball hat and the really cool tribal tattoo on his bicep.
Oh no. Oh my gosh. Oh no.
He's like the Ed Hardy. He's like wearing the Ed Hardy version of
Yoda. I think I know what his name is now.
Triple X?
I am Yoda's younger, cooler brother, am I?
Triple Y.
You may call me Yodog.
Yo, dog! Oh my gosh! I thought it was gonna be Broda.
Yeah, Broda.
I strongly considered Broda, but no, he's Yo Dog.
Yo dog.
At least it's not Choda.
No.
Oh.
No. Yoda was like a Broda to me. In fact, all of these rad troopers are like my Brodas.
Okay, now we're really in heaven or something. I don't know what this is.
I foresaw your coming here. Did I? Much to discuss, have we? And I think on that amazing cliffhanger, we'll wrap up this session. Guys, we have one more big session to wrap up this giant adventure arc. Obviously, This has been a very tight story that I told today. It really advanced the plot and was just from the outrageous cartoon-style trap antics, the naked Gippy Bindoo hordes, to the absurdist funeral.
You killed a lot of people, though.
It's all tight.
Yeah.
You killed three characters.
Two of them were you. And
I thought I was going to die.
Two of them were him.
Yeah.
Wait. One of them were you, and two of them were him.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, one was a fake out on you.
That's true. So technically four.
You almost got Yerp.
That's right.
You didn't.
We've got a big one. Much to discuss, have we, particularly regarding your friend, Tamaya.
Why am I not turning into light?
Boom. So we'll end up on that note. Guys, thank you so much for playing tonight. Thank you so much for watching.
Thanks for watching, everybody.
I will be back in 2 weeks with the final episode in Voice in the Abyss. Oh, and thanks for all the awesome donations, guys.
Yes,
this was a really
good
video.
Thank you, guys. You guys are too kind.
Guys, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
May the force be with you.